I'm still Stephen Holt, yes, after all 24 years on the air. And I'm now having one of the happiest moments I've had yet at the Toronto Film International Film Festival, because I'm at the Out There Partay Lounge with Melissa DiMarco, another legend.
You're so sweet.
You're Thank sweet. You, you are wow. so sweet. And you're so famous, and you're just busting out all over. You're in Buffalo now?
I know. Isn't that crazy? It's
so
nice.
That's excellent.
I love it. And it's so much fun. And having you here is an honor for me, by the way. So thank you for being here. This is pretty amazing.
Thank you for being on my show, finally, after all these years.
I know. We get to hang out, party, go see movies, chat about it all.
Yeah. Yeah. So have you seen any? It's the Toronto International Film Festival, folks.
Right, right. It's just that because, tell me if this is your experience.
Okay.
Because there's so many movies, it's all a big blur. I've seen so many films, it's like, which one is Zac Efron in? Which one is? It's like, it's a big blur.
Oh, you
blur.
Saw that one?
I did.
All right, I'm not gonna go there. I didn't see it. I saw Anna Karenina.
Did you like it?
Loved it.
Is that your favorite so far?
Yes.
Oh, really?
Yes. Yes.
That? Really?
Yes, it was. Ooh. That's the audience. Okay. I'm the target audience for that movie.
Are
if
you?
Gay men and women are going to like Anna Karenina, straight men, not so much. Okay. It's like, what are they doing? They're in the theater in those old dresses. What?
What's going on?
What's Russia? Are they French? What is this?
Now, what was one you didn't like, but you're going to whisper that to me? Or you're going to share it with the world?
I don't go to movies that I don't like.
I can't.
I'm far too old for that. Just see things that I like or might love, you know?
It's good. It's true.
You know, I work for myself, mm-hmm. so I just tell myself what to do, and I know what I like. And
you are your own boss.
And I didn't... Oh, I did not go see The Master because I knew I probably wouldn't like
right.
it.
Right. Well, that's good.
So I skipped it.
Because you don't want to say anything bad about a movie, right? You want to try and keep
it positive. Oh, I do constantly. I'm a critic. Supposed to. Hey, Paul Thomas Anderson. Okay, it's official. Why didn't they get me in? I guess they know I don't like his movies pretty much. But anyway, that was the big squeal up here. Did you do anything with that, The Master? We can't talk about
See,
it.
Yeah, I don't, you know.
You don't say anything bad about anybody.
I
love you.
I don't. I try not to, right? But it must be fun. That's what I love about you. You can go in and you can be, you know, you do both.
I don't hold back, Melissa. I'm
That's
known for
like
that. That's why
you.
They keep tuning in 24 years. I'm going to have a 25th anniversary in
really?
December. I don't know what I'm... It's Pearl Harbor was the day my show started. I mean, that was December 8th was the day that first aired.
Well,
so
we need to... Is it 25 years? You're not
It
kidding.
Will be 25 years in December. I'll have to come back to Toronto
well,
and celebrate.
Congratulations in advance.
Oh, thank
That's all
you,
I gotta say,
honey.
In advance.
Well, let's talk a little bit about you, then. Since you don't say anything,
have a drink on that.
You don't say anything bad about anybody, but you're on here in your seventh season, I think, in
yes,
Canada.
Yes, it is.
And you're
very
an
good. Yes.
Canadian icon.
Well, thank you, thank you. No, the show Out There with Melissa DiMarco is in its seventh season, and
That's
it's
awesome.
Yeah, and it's so much fun because, as you know, we have a lot of stars on the show, but it's about the behind the scenes and the humor of the real things that happen to us, right? I mean, we all know the stories, things that go wrong, things that are right that the audience never gets to see. So it's really getting that window into the behind the scenes.
Yeah.
And it's done, it's not a reality show. It's more of a you know, following the life of an entertainment journalist, which is me. So there you go.
And it's hilarious, and Thanks. And you're great on it. You look so beautiful on the air. You're so photogenic. Oh, my God, you know.
I need to hang around you way more often.
Oh, okay, all right. Deal.
I'm in.
Okay, but we're actually in a building that you have a mm-hmm. duplex suite, my dear.
Oh, you like it?
I like it. And all your sponsors are prominently displayed here.
Yes.
We can talk about all of them if you
okay.
like.
Well,
what
okay.
are they?
Okay. Well, every day when you come to the Out There Hospitality Suite,
okay.
we open up with some Melita coffee every morning.
Melita.
Yes.
Okay.
And La Roca Bakery gives us all the you know, baked goods in the morning. So we make
wow.
sure. It's not just about us.
I need to be here in the morning.
Yeah, you should. It's like everybody on the media floor loves to come in here because we feed everybody. And it's about really networking and people meeting. And then around noon, oh my gosh, I feel like I'm telling you all my little secrets. It's like we have a wine from Herndon Estates wine, and then San Pellegrino's for the you know, keeping people fresh during the interviews so we don't drink during the interviews. And we sample this with Miss Vicky Chips, and we have an Italian place called Camara's Pizzeria Ristorante. It's an Italian theme, you know, because
are you Italian?
Italian, yeah. Heritage, honey. So yeah, so it's all about pasta and pizza and all like good carbs. It's all about carbs.
All my great loves of my life were Italian.
So. Really?
Well, they were guys, right? Should we say a shout out to your fabulous producer, Rebecca?
Yes. You know, you cut.
She is so awesome
to see Rebecca, not me, Rebecca.
Well, you know, she gives me the new, the Tiff news in chunks, you know, and sound bites. That's what the word is.
Yes,
she just, well, she's felt this year that everybody had booked everything opposite each other. It's just been nuts.
Has it been crazy? The red carpets and everything have been like
at the same time.
Exactly.
And then you can't, there's only one Melissa. You can't be on three carpets.
Exactly. Like, what am I supposed to do? So I've been juggling, but it's all about wearing the right stilettos.
She's got that right. She's got that right. Yeah.
And because I can run in these. So
I bet you
can. So it's like going like there was what was it last night, Flip? It was like we had there was Tom Hanks or Robert De Niro. Hello. I mean, they're both like, what are you gonna do now? You know, it's
what
like,
did you do?
Well, Bobby and I have a little bit of a relationship of hitting-ness.
He's Italian too. I get it. Yes.
But we did a whole thing in Tribeca. So
okay.
We decided Tom Hanks. Which, you know what he did? He actually threw my cell phone, my data device, broke it in three pieces.
No.
I know.
Tom, that's not your image.
I know, he was saving me from technology.
Oh, okay.
He was saving me from myself. It was a good thing. It was a very good thing.
Right, I don't even have a cell phone, so.
See, this is the thing. That's what he was trying to get at, is that these are things that are
I just have a television
down.
Show.
I know.
A blog, you know.
You're too busy for me.
Yeah, I know. I can't.
You have no time for that.
Right. Don't bother me. Get that out of
exactly.
That thing out of here.
Exactly.
Anyway, so what's been the high point? For you,
for me,
Melissa DiMarco,
actually, you know what?
From out there,
so sweet. The high point is actually, truthfully, having people like you here, and it really is because this is a great networking opportunity.
And it's fun.
We're having fun. It's so much
real.
Fun because it is about like the movies and entertainment. So part of seeing the movies and critiquing them and doing interviews to promote other movies. Every year, what I love about our suite is that people come in here and movies are made. Television series last year were produced. People came together, and it's about emerging filmmakers meeting people in the industry, and deals are done. And that's not necessarily what I thought I'd be doing when I started this years ago, but it's such a cool thing that we've grown enough that we can actually be part of that process. So for me, that's the coolest part, is seeing new people, the people in the business kind of making things happen, and we're a part of that, which is good.
I know. It's, you get to be behind the scenes, even if you, like me, want to be in front of the camera all the time. You do see how it all goes on.
Isn't
and
great?
You see, you know, the pluses and the minuses, you know, like,
so good.
Oh, like this. I was so busy today. You're going to love this. I was so busy today. This is my Laura Linney shirt. You know, I was doing Hyde Park on the Hudson.
Nice.
And it was totally appropriate for her movie.
I think that's
and then
choice.
I forgot that End of Watch was today. I thought it was tomorrow. So,
Steven.
Not the right shirt for a cop thriller. But Jake. Him, yeah, Jake Gyllenhaal,
yeah,
Jake,
looking at you going.
Was laughing his head off. He goes, it's fine, I love it. And his director said that,
same
too.
Thing. You see, and that didn't that sort of open up the conversation?
Yes.
It just lightened the mood.
Yes, it
and
did.
That's
from talking about murder and cops and crime. And
you just brought it down to some good.
Yeah, they
right?
were they were rolling in the aisles. And you know, since I last saw you, I've become the Oscar messenger.
I know.
So I can talk about that. The best film, I mean, Anna Karenina is so far out there. I wonder if the Academy could get it.
Really? You think that they're just not going to get the whole thing?
Well, I think they'll get it. I think they'll nominate it. But Keira Knightley, OMG.
Really?
Did you see Keira up here?
She's like, hello.
Lovely.
I mean, lovely, lovely, lovely.
Sweet, yeah.
She's always something very... How many times have you interviewed her? Because if not, she's very shy, but so beautiful.
The more times you interview her, she opens up more.
Oh, good, good. So you've interviewed... Obviously, more of them than I have.
probably. She was lovely. She was lovely.
So, do you see any Oscar picks already? Because
Yes, of course I have. I've been doing it all year. It's almost done.
No. From Tiff.
Well, there's Marion Cotillard and Rustin Bound.
Yes, I love that.
Did you see that? Yes. You did see that. Okay.
Oh, yes.
I got up at 5:30 in the morning to get to an 8:45 press and industry screen.
It was good.
No makeup, hair, and no legs.
I know. Brilliant. She is, like, you know, she's gorgeous. She's just stunning.
I know. I'll tell you a little Marion Cotillard story. The first time I interviewed her for La Vie en Rose, I didn't really know what bounce was. She had a bounce board here, a bounce board here, a bounce board here. There was so much bounce, I was bouncing. We both looked fabulous, and she was only in her early 30s at the
time. She's bouncing everywhere.
Yeah, she didn't need it. She was so beautiful anyway. But, she's great in this movie. Her inner, with no vanity, nothing.
No, and it's great when Halle Berry talks about feeling really comfortable in her own skin when she does
movies. She's so beautiful. I just saw her in the hallway.
I know. She's like... She gets more gorgeous. I mean, this girl is like crazy.
I think she said, I just saw, I came from Melissa.
There you go. You see what I mean?
So she looked happy.
Aw, you're so sweet. So how come I only see you once a year? This is not good.
Because I live in New York and it's freezing up here in Toronto, right?
It's cold in New York too, not as cold. Still, a little bit. So I'm going to come see you.
Okay, all right.
Come see you.
Yeah, we can do that. We can work it out. But anyway, listen, I don't want to take up
of
your time.
We have to go party a little bit.
Yes. Well, she does. I just sit here and talk to Rebecca. I know. That's my party.
What are you on? What's up for you tonight?
This is it. I'm the highlight. It's been, darling, after you, the rest of the festival is really dull.
I love you.
Oh, okay.
You're so good for my ego. I'm just telling you.
Well, you're a star, and you should be encouraged.
Thank you.
In your career, to go move forward.
Well,
you know,
thank you.
And I know it's not easy for women in this business to proceed, you know, because it's a male dominated business.
It is, but I got pipes.
Look at her. She'll be running for president of Canada
there
next.
You go.
Right?
That's right there. All right, thank you so much.
Thank you, honey.
It's a pleasure to see you again. Thank you for being on my show and for me being on your show.
Oh my God, it's a double.
All right.
A double header.
A double header right here. Okay, so can you just a little promo for me that you're on my show? You're out there with Melissa DiMarco.
I'm Stephen Holt. I'm out there with Melissa DiMarco.
Oh, awesome. Mwah. Oh, and I got lipstick all over you.
Oh, that's okay. I usually put it here, but...